So welcome to Yoga with Smiles. Dr. Sharda from Vrindavan Yoga and me from Smile Makers Training love to bring this session to you again and again. So today our topic is going to be about acidity. And one of the reasons why people have acidity issues is because of this burning feeling what they have inside them, because they do not trust the process of life. So today my topic of conversation is about trust. And as usual, I would like to start with a small story. So imagine you have gone on a cave exploration trip, and by mistake, you are inside one dark cave, and by mistake, you have got separated from the group. And you find yourself at the edge of something which looks quite deep. And here you are on the edge and you do not know what to do. And you are screaming for help, and suddenly somebody answers and he says, jump. Now you have two choices. You can either jump or you can go back, but you have no idea where to go back because you're going to get lost. My question to you is, that man tells you, I am a bodybuilder, I can carry your weight, you jump, I will catch you. My question is, will you jump? Ask yourself, whether you jump or not, leave that in your head. But suppose you were a child, maybe 8, 10 years old, and you heard your father's voice down there, and your father says, jump. Would you jump? Of course. Why? What is the difference between the first and the second person? Because in the second case, you have absolute trust and you'll say, your father says jump, and you do 1, 2, 3, and then you just jump down. And you know that your father is going to hold you and catch you. So because you trust your father. And you may not trust this unknown bodybuilder who says that he's a bodybuilder. So my question to you is, you need to ask yourself, how many people are there in this world whom you can trust wholeheartedly? How many people, you can just spend some time and make a list of people that if you want to jump or if you were to fall down, then would they catch you? So, you know, this is a very interesting question, and I would like you to, you know, all of us are very careful about our future, and we all open financial bank accounts, don't we? We want to invest money in right, left, up, this, all different places, because we want to feel secure about our finances in the future. Today, I'm requesting you to think about opening an emotional bank account. Have you heard of the term emotional bank account? So every person that you meet, especially people you consider as close family members or friends or whoever, you need to invest some time in that emotional bank account with them. So emotional bank account is when you give, when you contribute, when you serve wholeheartedly. You know, you're building that goodwill, you're building that relationships, you're building that trust with them. And automatically, they will trust you and you will also get trust in return. Okay, you can trust them, they can trust you whenever you build. So consider this aspect of emotional bank account and spend some time. You know, we are spending a lot of time with so many other things that we are doing, but just consider whether you can spend more time in building your emotional bank account, especially with children. You know, we always, with our children, the way we bring them up is do this, don't do that, controlling this, controlling that, you know. But instead of that, we can just give and show some love, some kindness, some empathy, some care. You know, we have done that over the years and we have built that bank account. And then today, you know, we can trust our children for everything that we want, or it can be your spouse or whoever you think of it. Okay? So trust is something which is a two-way process. You know, they have to trust you and you have to trust them and you have to build on it. Good tip?